You're going to see a lot of formulas in chemistry, several of which you will be required to memorize. But instead of having to memorize all of the different formulas of each formula solved for each variable, your life will be so much easier if you understand how to rearrange one formula into multiple formulas all solved for different variables. And note, a variable is a symbol or letter that represents a value. To understand how to rearrange a formula, we need to review these algebra rules. When you are trying to move a variable to the opposite side of the formula, you must do the opposite operation and do this for both sides of the formula. I know, this may feel really basic, but please stay with me. Don't skip this part because we'll be going over more complicated formulas that most students get wrong because they didn't review these rules. All right, so say we wanted to solve for x for both of these questions. We look at what isn't allowing x to be by itself, which is the y. And since y is being added, we must do the opposite operation, which is subtraction. We must subtract y from both sides to get x. Same concept for this next question. Y is now being subtracted, so we will do the opposite operation and add both sides by y. This is what our x equals. We can see this again for multiplication and division. Let's solve for x for each question. X and y are being multiplied, so in order to get x by itself, we will do the opposite operation and divide by y to both sides. This is what x now equals. Apply this concept again. X and y are being divided. In order for x to be by itself, we perform the opposite operation and multiply both sides by y. And this is our answer. This next trick works for when you have two fractions that are set equal to each other. If you don't want to deal with the fractions, then you can multiply diagonally. So multiply the a and the d, then set this equal to b times c. Note, since this is being multiplied, the order does not matter. We could have written this as dA and CB. Moving on to roots and powers. To get rid of a power, simply raise both sides by the same root. For example, to solve for x and remove this power of 2, we will take the square root of both sides. The square root and power of 2 now cancel out to get this as our answer for x. If we wanted to get rid of a root, we would raise it to the same power. So to get rid of a square root, we need to square both sides. The square root is now gone, and this is our answer for x. We can see this again with other powers and roots that are not 2. Again, to get rid of a power, simply take the root of both sides, and the root would be the same number as the power. This is the opposite for when we want to get rid of a root, simply raise both sides by the same power of the root. On to the examples. This is a formula you'll see in thermochemistry. We're asked to solve for Q. Since we want Q to be by itself, we need to move the W to the opposite side by subtracting W from both sides. The W's now cancel out, and we can flip this around to show Q is equal to this. The most common mistakes I've seen students make is with the gas law formulas. Here's the ideal gas law. Let's solve for N. Start with asking, what isn't allowing N to be by itself? The R and the T. And since everything is being multiplied, we need to perform the opposite operation and divide both the R and T together to both sides. This now cancels, and I'll flip this around to get this as our answer. Here's another gas law. Let's solve for V1. V1 is here, and what's not allowing it to be by itself is its denominator of T1. So we will perform the opposite operation and multiply both sides by T1. The T1s now cancel, and looking at the right side, we can combine this. Remember that there's actually a 1 here as our denominator, and we can multiply straight across to get this as our V1. Using the same gas law, let's now solve for T1. Since these are two fractions set equal to each other, we can use our trick and multiply diagonally to get rid of the fractions. When we do this, we get V1 times T2 and V2 times T1. Again, order doesn't matter. We could have said this was T2 times V1 and T1 times V2 and so on. Next, we can divide both sides by V2 to get T1 by itself. I'll flip this around to get this as our answer. Rearranging the combined gas law tends to confuse a lot of students, and let's practice this and solve for T2. We again have two fractions set equal to each other, so we can use our trick and multiply diagonally to get rid of the fractions. We'll multiply P1 V1 times T2 to get all these variables together on one side. Set this equal to P2 V2 times T1 on the other side. Again, order doesn't matter here since we are multiplying. We are solving for T2, so we need to get rid of anything that is not allowing T2 to be by itself. We will divide P1 and V1 at the same time to both sides. These cancel, and this is our answer for T2. Ready for a challenge? Let's use the formula from Bohr's model and solve for N initial. Since N initial is in parentheses, we must get rid of everything outside of the parentheses first. So since this number is being multiplied, we will perform the opposite operation of division and divide this number to both sides and cancel this out. Now that there is nothing left outside of the parentheses, we can drop the parentheses. This fraction that is being subtracted isn't allowing N initial to be by itself, so we will perform the opposite operation and add both sides by this fraction. Unfortunately, we can't use our trick and multiply diagonally since that trick only works when there is only one fraction on each side of the equal sign. Instead, we will multiply both sides by N initial. There is no need to distribute since the goal is to isolate N initial. Instead, we can divide both sides by everything in parentheses since these two are being multiplied. Almost done, we need to get rid of this squared by taking the square root of both sides. This is our answer. Okay, I'll admit that one was just crazy. It will be a lot easier when you are given the values of the variables and only asked to find one variable, but it still is really important to know how to properly move values and variables around. So click the link in the description and practice this by completing all the practice problems, then move on to the next video in this playlist.